And NATO says that any use of chemical weapons by the Syrian regime would trigger an immediate international response. The Alliance Secretary General's comments follow American warnings that Syria could be considering the use of chemical weapons to crush the rebellions. Let's bring in Robert Baer for some perspective on this. He's a CNN contributor and a former CIA operative, and he joins us now live from California. First of all, what do we know about this alleged chemical weapons capability of Syria?
Well, Hala, it's not alleged. The Syrians have very advanced capabilities. The American government has been aware of this for the last 20 years. The Syrians had built this stuff themselves, imported some of it, and it was a deterrent meant for Israel. It was to replace nuclear weapons. It's a very, very lethal and of great worry to Washington. I think when the president brings this up and has transmitted this warning to Syria, he's not keen to get involved in Syria. He's just very, very worried about these chemical weapons.
And what does it tell us that U.S. sources are able, according to them, according to sources that are talking to our own reporters, including Barbara Starr, able to determine that it's not just the movement of these reported stockpiles, but potentially the mixing of chemical weapons capability that could mean that Syria is getting ready to use some of it? I mean, how do you determine that? How do you get a hold of that intelligence?
Almost definitely from intercepts. You see orders going down to various battalions. They can't hide this stuff. It goes across radio networks. You hear soldiers on the ground talking about it. This is called chatter. It's very easy to pick up.
So it's more than satellite surveillance. This is on the ground sort of intelligence gathering, yes?
Well, presumably, if they're mixing sarin, it's a binary agent. If they're mixing it, it's done indoors, and you couldn't see this from satellites.
Mm-hmm. Now, there's another way to look at this, according to some analysts over the last 24, 48 hours, which is, you know, perhaps that in some cases the chemical weapons capability of Syria is being exaggerated, that this is Western powers essentially laying the groundwork for, a little bit down the road, some sort of intervention or arming of the rebels. What do you make of that analysis?
You know, frankly, Hall, I don't buy it. This president has been reluctant. He was reluctant to get into Libya. A long time ago, he could have gotten into Syria, put CIA in there, gotten a lethal finding to support the rebels. He's been very hesitant to enter any of these conflicts brought about by the Arab Spring. I just can't see him wanting to get into Syria. I mean, Syria is going to be much worse than Libya if, in fact, it progresses the way it is. Mm-hmm. And things are truly bad there. And the fact that the Turks have asked for Patriot missiles, probably to defend themselves against gas or liquid sarin, it tells me a lot. This is a conflict that nobody wants in. But on the other hand, if it spins out of control, it's going to infect the entire region.
Well, certainly it would have a much bigger impact than Libya because it's a bigger country, more population, geographically certainly more central, borders with many other very strategically important countries. The question, though, is what is the end game? I mean, you have certain people saying this is a matter of weeks, this regime is going to collapse. Others, a war of attrition, we're looking at 6 months, 9 months. I mean, how do you make any kind of determination if you're a strategist in Washington or anywhere else?
Well, I'm not sure I pay much attention to that, but I listen to the Alawites. I've been very close to them for the last 30 years, and they tell me, they assure me, that this regime is not going to give up. They look at this as an existential battle, that if they lose it, they will be slaughtered by the rebels, who are many of them are Sunni militants, Salafis. They truly believe their existence is at stake. And if they have their backs to the wall, they will use sarin. I have no doubt about it. We have to look at this from the perspective of the regime, of why they're fighting and what they're trying to do. It's the only way to understand the conflict. You know, intellectually, we cannot take sides in this. We just have to understand what's happening. And having spent all these years in Syria, mm-hmm. I think the conflict is dire, as most people, as a lot of people say it is.